anything.
So, again, we have Bas Cornelijn Slijper.
That's correct. I'm very happy to see you again.
You are, I think it's the third time here. last year you told me that your project of a bar, like an arcade bar with old computers and old machines, was pretty much discontinued. But now you have some news to give.
Yes, you told me mm-hmm. that if you won the lottery, you yeah. want to pay for me the new museum.
I have not won the lottery.
No, but the museum is there.
The museum is there. It's Explain
not,
it.
It's not in Horen. Uh-huh. It's in Purmerend. I met Johan de Punder. He's a fanatic MSX user. And he asked me, can you do something for my company? Of course.
What?
So I'm looked there and I came in a building of 12,000 square meter full of gaming, modern gaming, game artists, game developers, game companies, a gaming hall with PlayStation 5, with Xbox, with Nintendo Switch, with PCs, tournaments with FIFA.
Uh-huh.
A stadium, everything.
Yeah.
So I asked him, what can I do for you? And Johan said to me, I want to make a retro area.
Uh-huh.
I want a complete experience for the customers, for the visitors. And you are the person who knows a lot of things from old computers. Not only MSX, but other systems like Commodore, Videopac.
Uh-huh.
We walked to that building. And I was a bit confused. It's too modern for me. I don't understand the PlayStation 5. I don't understand how a PC is working. then we had a little try out on the summer holiday for 1 week with 10 consoles. 2 video packs, 2 MSX computers, 2 Commodores and a few others.
Uh-huh.
And it was a big success. Mm-hmm. A lot of people get good memories about that time. And want to play games like Hyper Olympics.
So pretty much it's like a corner for the daddies that of the people that plays there in the arena.
Yes.
Because I've been talking to Kundals and Anne de Rat and the H20. It's going to be the same place where the God of 40 is going to be. It's going to happen.
Yes, that's the same place, and that is a big coincidence.
Uh-huh.
Years ago, I talked with Anne before the corona. We have to do something with MSX 40 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we have to do it. But then the corona came. And
and everything was screwed.
Yes, and after the corona, I was at H20. Mm-hmm. And that's the perfect place to have an exhibition or an event like this, because everything you will find there, music studios, video studios, YouTube, Google, everything you will find there.
Uh-huh.
So Anne asked Koen Dols and Wiebe to help with that event. And I'm also there helping, and they make the ideas. And I will look at the building, if it's possible, what they want. With sound, with music, with booths, stand holders, visitors, food. Mm-hmm. So
right now, how many people you could hold there?
A lot of people.
Well, that's not very exact.
No. For example,
400.
Within a few days, I have an event. I'm just a little bit like an event manager, and I will arrange a games experience tour to the building.
Uh-huh.
Wednesday I get 250 students in one time.
200?
250 students.
250.
Want to have a game tour with a Formula One simulator, with VR gaming, and also with retro gaming. And also my Philips VideoPack collection, the Philips game consoles.
Yeah.
as a very beautiful place. I get that from Johan. Nice cabinets. All my consoles are there, and I'm your guide at that day.
Okay.
I tell nice stories, what you want to hear.
Okay, so you work there.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, okay. That's
and it's exactly what my plans were for my own game hall.
Okay.
Only this is a little bit bigger.
Yeah, yeah, and without a without a restaurant, because you had the idea to have a snacks and...
Yes, there is a restaurant and there is a bar. Okay. And you can get all kinds of drinks, like beer, cola, coffee, wine.
Okay, I see, I see. Then it's great to know that at the end, somehow, your project got alive in another direction.
Yes.
And without me winning the lottery. You had not to wait me to win the lottery.
And of course, even I don't get any money from you, you are welcome.
Oh, thank you.
It's a big place, H20 Esports Center in Amsterdam. There's an esports stadium. There are professional gaming inside the building. Gaming for big money.
Okay. Okay.
Big events for sometimes 1,000 people.
I hope that the MSX can make a great event there.
I'm sure, and I'm 100% sure that Anne, Koen and Wiebe are the right persons between all our MSX users to do this event.
Okay.
They are very serious, and I want to help them with some practical things.
Okay, okay. Then also, when it comes to the spare parts and items to fix the MSX, is there anything new?
No, there is nothing new. Only I have enough stock for everyone. I bought new drive belts again, new PCBs. The only thing is new, and I'm not happy with it, that the parts for making cables, the parts to repair computers, are more expensive.
Yeah.
For example, I sell a drive belt for €7.50. I have to pay in Japan, because I buy originals, almost €8 each. And when I buy 100 pieces one time. So I'm not happy with that.
Okay.
But I want to help you. So I keep the price low because it's a hobby for me. And if you are happy and it costs me a few euros, no problem.
Oh, well. No problem. If we have to pay the price,
we pay.
Okay, okay. Then thank you very much for your time, Bas.
Yes, of course.
We can meet in Goto 40.
Yes, sure, Ramon. It was nice to meet you again. And it's feeling you are a very good friend of me.
Well, I try to.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you to you, Bas.